with Ariyagya, Sankirtan Yagya, which means kirtans, festivals, namahatas, and so many things. So I said this morning, when you have your core group who does all the deity worship, it's a lot of energy goes into the daily puja. I think the congregation doesn't appreciate how much effort goes into maintaining a daily program for the deities. And that somehow everybody can bite into that, participate in that yajna. That's our pancharatrik side here of the temple. I mean, serve the Lord and the Lord's here, but and the yajna that pleases Gornitai here are presiding deities, which is very rare. Because the Panihat and Gornitai are eternally resident, so we put Gornitai in the center. But they worship, they're being worshipped as before a personality of Godhead and expansion devotees. I was thinking that there's so much could be done. But how Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda, when he first went back to Bengal, he just got everybody to chant. I remember saying Indudumna at the Woodstock Festival. It's all these young people go for rock and roll and everything. And he's got one booth where it's all sells Indian stuff. In one corner they got drums. So there's always like 10 youths to sit down there with these bongos and different different shaped drums, start bong, beating drums. People like drum beats. Just having a Hari Nam with lots of drums. People like it. I think the Bhakti Tirthamars introduced different kinds of drums into the life of Gunagraha. What's his name? Gunagrahi Maharaj has his different. What's that? African drums or Caribbean?
Jimbi.
They call them Congos?
Jimbi.
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 Very popular. Yeah.
So what is the place and what is the things that are going to be attractive to people? Like, I was just at the festival in Byron Bay, as I talked about last night, how they had this Rath Yatra, New Year's Eve.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Taking the Jagannath around and everybody's in the street trying to enjoy it some crazy way. And here comes the Rath Yatra to come out and pull the rat. They start pulling the rats.
Yeah.
And they got to, the swamis have to have like a circle around them. Because there was one of Bhakti that Madhav, what's his name? Visrambha Madhav.
Yeah. Bhakti Visrambha Madhav.
Bhakti Visrambha Madhav. He was there in the kirtan. And then he saw that some young reveler tried to climb up and hug me. Because that's the mood, everybody hugs everybody. You know. But I had my cord and I had my felling stuff. When we saw that, he got freaked out. So then he ran up and jumped up on top of the rock. Just stayed up there. It's too heavy there. There's an old lady that comes every year to the and stands behind the rock. When people try to climb up the rock, She has a broom, she has like a cane or something, and taps him, get down. Behave! Do naughty boy! I didn't know, because I'm the front. I met her at the end, I said, oh, I come here every year. It's my 12th year or something. Wow. I keep them from climbing up to that. But, you get the people love to sing and dance. They love to, One lady came up to Ramaya Swami and told him, thank you so much for being here. Because you come here every year, and I heard some people saying that this is really the spirit of the whole New Year's festival. They were going to not go this year because it's a big expense, and some of the leaders were doing a rock and roll festival and catering instead. And when the city council heard, they wrote a personal letter requesting them to please come and do it on the country. Normally we had to go and ask, you know, they're asking us, 50,000 people at least on the street. So it's a different environment, so what is that? We have the juggernauts, got a big strobe light in the town.
Right.
The juggernaut turns yellow and different colored lights flashing. It's kind of not the normal route the juggernaut. I was going to say, kind of disco route. That's the time and the place, you know. It's very, everything's very respectful. And people, and you got these muscle men pulling the rods. So you guys go around the world and sell the different kind of environments in different places. Of course, they're in Malaysia, mainly we're preaching to the Indian community. And they have, in Kuala Lumpur, they have 57 Ramatas last year, and this year they have 90. So they almost doubled it. Hmm. But then in Penang, they started something new. They started preaching to the Chinese people, which, you know, I've been telling them to do, but they haven't been doing it. So they've been really, they almost had one Chinese group in Kuala Lumpur, but they never expanded. But now in Penang, they're going to expand. They have 4 Chinese groups. Mm-hmm. Last year was 1, and 2, now up to 4. Mm-hmm. And this year, the Subhata Rat was all Chinese. People pulling the Subhata Rat.
Yeah.
So it's really nice to see,
yeah, yeah, you
know, Chinese devotees. So it's like that time and place.
Like the Bible,
huh?
Like somebody's eyes.
I don't know why they chose him. Goddess
of mercy.
They have a goddess of mercy. Subhadra looks like a goddess of mercy. I think Subhadra is the most merciful.
Yeah.
Subhadra Devi Ki.
Yeah.
So. By the way, it was amazing, you know, the tsunami came, which was such a disastrous thing. And our temple is not so far from the ocean side in Penang, but the water came within 100 meters of our temple and stopped and turned back.
Wow.
And then our temple in Chennai is 500 meters from the beach. It's just, you know, Chennai, Ichambakam, but the Golden Beach, so I had the Golden Beach, but it's on the other side of the road, but also I didn't get hit by the water, it didn't reach. So we were, Krishna saved them, the devotees, even though they were very close to the water. So now they're distributing prasadam. And they still are in Sri Lanka, but the people are actually beginning themselves more and more together. The limit how much you can distribute prasadam every month or two until they get their new houses and that. But then they found that not all the fishermen like to. Some places they like vegetarian food, some people they want fish. So, initially when you're really hungry, they all liked it. So they kind of focused, but they found that people were being traumatized and that they appreciated the cute. So, I mean, some ladies told me in Chennai that they couldn't sleep by the beach where their houses were, you know, destroyed. Even if they put up a little hut, they were just too afraid.
Yeah.
To wake up and see your son swept away by a gigantic wind, you know, it's like they're freaked out. So they stay there all day by the beach, but they go up to sleep far away. They still have nightmares. So kirtans are being highly appreciated. It's soothing them, it's giving them some. So the Lada kirtans are found that a lot of Russian devotees flew down in Sri Lanka and they're doing kirtan. And then now they say that, well, for the long range, we have an orphanage run by ladies. The wife of the president has a group of ladies that runs an orphanage. And there's a tsunami orphans. So they're going to get maybe over 100 orphans from the tsunami whose parents were lost. Because the Christian missionaries, in the name of these big, you know, Ox families, that I don't know which groups are doing it, but some of the Christian groups too. And they take the orphans and they convert them into, well, they're all Hindu orphans and Buddhist orphans. They make them change their religion. So some of the local groups are upset because, you know, in the name of charity, they're not taking advantage of it. So they're really happy that we're giving an alternative to people. The nearest and kin can select, which you know, if they don't mind, okay, but at least they have a choice. So they're thinking to use time, place, and circumstance that the people have enough food. If they have, we have surplus money, use it to maintain the orphans, the tsunami orphans, create a fund for them, at least for some years. Which is also food relief, feeding them. They have them in houses that we can build. Buddhist lady, you know, a movie star, donated the land and the house for the orphanage, like if you go to a children's family home or something. So it's like in different places, you know, there's different opportunities that devotees take. South America, the devotees, Namhaptas, Bhakti Bhiksha groups are expanding. We have about 10 or so, 6 to 10 in Peru, in Lima, and other different places. Namhata put on the Rath Yatra in Buenos Aires. They built a Rath Yatra for a temple, a chariot. But they didn't know how to build the telescopic rats. They had to do some technological. Jayananda Prabhu designed the telescopic rat. They didn't know how to do telescopic, so the rat wasn't so tall. In India, they have special designs for different sizes rats. So like this, around the world you find different situations, different. They probably, when he was preaching in Fiji, we heard that there are no snakes. And there's talk about a gigantic multi-headed snake somewhere, a dragon or something like that in the water. So it sounds like Kaliya. And where there's Kaliya, then there's no snakes. So that's why Prabhupada established the Kaliya Krishna temple in Fiji. Heard recently Bhara Krishna Maharaj installed another temple. I don't know which temple that was. Huh? Another island, another place. The locals did it. He was there. I said, no, as you can see there. Like all over the world. This sacrifice is mainly taking advantage of what are the possibilities that are available. What's interesting is that in New York, I don't know if they still do it, but for some time Maharaj had a flatbed truck with the Hari Nam going around the city.